It's AumSum time!
What if we drink too much coffee?
Too much of anything is bad. This is the new AumSum mantra.
Wow, AumSum. Coffee contains a drug called caffeine. Overconsumption of caffeine will lead to the following problems. Firstly, it will lead to caffeine-induced anxiety disorder. Secondly, we will suffer from insomnia. That is, we will not be able to sleep. We might stare at the stars all night. Thirdly, potassium levels will go down, which will lead to heart palpitations or irregular heartbeat. Fourthly, caffeine being acidic, it might damage the lining of our digestive tract and further worsen existing stomach ulcers. Fifthly, caffeine can act as a diuretic, leading to excess urine production and thus dehydration. Sixthly, caffeine has great laxative properties, but too much consumption can also lead to diarrhea. Lastly, overconsumption of caffeine may lead to development of chronic liver diseases. Is coffee good for health?
Nah. Cold coffee with whipped cream is the healthiest.
Oh, AumSum. Coffee definitely has some advantages associated with it. Coffee contains caffeine. It is a stimulant, which after consumption reduces tiredness and makes us feel more alert. Coffee is also a strong source of several powerful antioxidants. Some studies have shown that coffee is linked to reduced risk of a number of diseases like type 2 diabetes, Parkinson's, and Alzheimer's. But too much of something is never good for the body. Consuming too much coffee, that is, caffeine, can lead to anxiety and stress. In some extreme cases, it may also lead to heart palpitations and panic attacks. Lastly, caffeine present in coffee can be very addictive. If heavy coffee drinkers try to abstain from coffee for a few days, they may experience irritation, headaches, etc. Topic: caffeine. How does coffee keep you awake?
By throwing an overnight party.
Nah. When we perform our daily activities like thinking and playing, a byproduct called adenosine is produced. Adenosine slows down the brain activity.
But how?
In our brain, there are adenosine receptors which are perfectly molded for this adenosine. When the adenosine binds to these receptors, it activates them, causing to slow down the brain activity and thus making us feel sleepy. However, drinking coffee keeps us awake and we don't feel sleepy. This is because coffee contains a drug called caffeine, which after digestion reaches our brain. Caffeine is structurally similar to adenosine. Being similar, caffeine binds to the adenosine receptors and thus blocks the adenosine from binding. Hence, as adenosine does not bind, our receptors don't slow the brain activity. As a result, we remain awake. How is coffee decaffeinated?
Using a vacuum cleaner.
Coffee contains caffeine. Caffeine boosts our energy and keeps us focused for a short duration. However, caffeine can also cause headaches, nervousness, etc. Hence, decaffeinated coffee is a very good alternative. Now, there are various methods to decaffeinate coffee. One of them is solvent-based method. In this, green coffee beans are first soaked in hot water for several hours. This causes caffeine and flavor of coffee to get dissolved in hot water. Now, in the second step, the green coffee beans and hot water are separated. Then, using various solvents like methylene chloride or ethyl acetate, caffeine is removed from this water. Then this water, which still has the flavor of coffee in it, is added back to the coffee beans so that they reabsorb the flavor. In this way, coffee is decaffeinated without compromising its flavor. Topic: light and sound. Why do we see lightning before thunder? Don't go out tonight. A huge storm is coming. Look at the weather outside. See, there's a huge lightning strike.
Hooray!
Now, very soon, you're going to hear some thunder. I told you. Don't get scared. It's just thunder. Do you know why you saw the lightning before you heard the thunder? I will tell you. An interesting fact is that lightning and thunder occur at the exact same time. Then why do we see lightning first? This is because light travels faster than sound. The speed of light is 300 million meters per second, while the speed of sound is only 340 meters per second. Thus, the light from the lightning travels much faster to our eyes. As a result, we first see the lightning, shortly followed by the sound of thunder.